slide guitar. What a sound. Wow. There it is. That's the song, that's the sound. And imagine a 16-year-old kid hearing that and going, how the hell do you do that? I didn't know about slides. But I do now. And here's a little taste of what's to come in this video. The slide world is not a simple thing, is it? Which one do you, there's so many different ones. We're going to talk about some of that. Stay tuned. Thanks for listening. Hi, good morning. Don Anderson here. This is going to be a different kind of a recording here. I have a podcast, I guess. I put videos up all the time. I do some instruction, product information, and I play music. I play guitar and keyboards and stuff. My background is I've been in the industry for about 40 years plus or minus, probably more plus. Owned a music store for many, many years. I work in a music industry for years and been on the road and played in bands forever, so on and so forth. So I got a lot of stuff here that I forgot. So let's put it that way. People say, you know, you forgot more than people know. I absolutely forgot more than people know because I can remember some of it. Anyway, what I'm talking about today is coming up on my influence in the early days, you know, coming up through high school in the 70s, when I heard the Allman Brothers, that was it. I mean, Fillmore East was a biblical recording for me, like everybody. I'm not a special. I listened to that damn thing every freaking day. But in the very beginning, when I heard it and didn't see it, didn't read about it, didn't know much about who those guys were, and I heard Duane playing slide, initially, I didn't know slide. I didn't know what the hell he was doing. I'm like, what is that? And I'm bending string, trying to figure out, what is he doing that? Then, you know, Guitar Player Magazine, thank God. Slide! Anyway, that was it. I mean, not that I'm the world-known slide player, but that just hit me, man, that way of playing guitar. So, of course, like all of us idiots that do this, you know, I had to find out, well, what the hell is this? How do you do that? And, of course, we know that Duane had everything. He's had, you know, all kinds of different guitars that he's played slide on. But mostly, most notable is his SGs. And more notably, because you can play slide on anything. I can play slide on an acoustic guitar, on a cheap piece of shit. Matter of fact, my slide guitar that I've set up in my studio for slide is a cheaper instrument that looks to be a real one, but wherever it is. Here it is. Hold on. This is my slide guitar. Now, this one is a Les Paul Special. Not really a Les Paul. It's a Chinese. I don't know if it's Chinese. I never did any research on it. I just liked this one. It had P90s. It was just like a Special, like a Les Paul Special, double cutaway, you know, not one, but two cutaway. And this pickup is from a 50s Gibson that I yanked out of something and just to get that sound in here. Although this damn thing sounds almost as good. I hate to explain some of that stuff to people. Anyway, all right, it's not about the instrument because Duane played mostly a SG. The biggest thing about an SG is you can get up in here easily. I can get right up to here. Even a Les Paul with a cutaway, you still got to turn your hand and get this direction. You can't come in here straight up like you can on this one, right up to the end of the neck. It just, I don't know, just like SGs, these are very easy to reach. That's why they use them, I think. Anyway, I decided on this one because it sounds great. The thing that you can't cheat on, you can cheat on these, is the things they use. Now, slides can be, you know, I guess the typical when you know, somebody says play slide guitar, you pull out something that looks like this. It's a steel slide. You know, has that slidey sound. That's the one we're all familiar with. I can't stand these. I used them for years, and now I can't use them anymore. I just don't like them, the way they feel. And you know, geez, I'm trying to do what Duane's doing. I just don't have that round color he had. Well, Duane, well, let me just show you first the slides that are now. You can get metal ones like this, metal ones like this. You can get ceramic ones like this. You can get weird glass ones like this with plastic in the side, brass ones, and then a variety of glass ones. Now, there's the subject I want to talk about. We found out through sources back in the 70s that Duane was using Corsedon bottles, Corsedon cold medicine bottles. Just so happened that I was working at a pharmacy in high school, like a sophomore in high school, you know, 16-year-old kid. And I heard that. I said, Corsedon? I got that. So I was on a rampage. Any bottle that was the ripped labels or anything destructible that I was bottle was coming home with me. I brought home probably through the years, you know, I don't know, 7, 8, 10 of them. I don't know what I did with them. I still have 3. Now, this is special. These are 1970s Corsedon bottles. They stopped making these in like 81, 2 or something. And you can see that these bottles are milky. Like they're not clear glass. You can tell that they're, you can see all the, you know, how thick it is and how you can't hardly see through it. And they are thicker, and the glass is different. It's a different, it's not this beautiful, I don't know much about glass, but you can see these are just perfect, and these are not. They even have begun, D'Addario, years ago, started making these, because you couldn't find these. You know, certain people knew, like me, grabbed a bunch of them, but you couldn't find them. So D'Addario made a copy. It looks like this. Doesn't look anything like the original, though. And it's thinner glass. It's definitely thinner. And again, it looks pretty much essentially like just like regular glass, not like that glass, which is, you know, it's all, you can't even see through it. It's so thick and gunky. Like, you know, you can tell the glass is different. So the big question is, and I've been fighting it for years, is did he sound better? Is that possible? I mean, if I get a, let me turn this up a little bit. This is the one that I have liked. This is just a thick glass. I think the thickness is what got to me. But even these, when I go side by side with the original Corsedons, I don't know if I'm inventing something or it really has a tone to it. There's something about the inconsistency in the glass, you know. I don't know what the hell it is. You probably won't hear it right away when you play and you feel the vibration on your finger. I can see, I like this one, so this one doesn't bother me as much. Now, just quickly move over to a Corsedon bottle. These don't fit me so good anymore, they're too small. But I still love them. The made Corsedon bottle, the copy. Hear it? It's just the notes there, but there's a whole a sound that's not there without, hear it? It's just like, it's almost like there's a swelling tone. I can't explain it. They're different. damn it, they're different than anything here. I got these fancy schmancy, you know, I like this one too. It spins and you can play guitar. You still got your fingers free and then you spin it around. Some people like metal because it's got more attack, you know, hard, heavy, loud rock. It works great. But glass is so smooth and it's way more emotional. You know, the notes are a little slower attack and you got to be able to, I don't know, there's something magical about it. You know, I don't know what Duane Allman knew. He was only fucking 20 something years old. How did he know all this stuff? There's something about these. Thankfully, I still have three of them. I've seen these online for over $100 for a real one. And even then, well, no, I sold it. Like that. You can't find them. So I don't know what people would pay for these now. I don't know. But the point being, I'm trying to just illustrate the fact that there was something about these. And I can't explain it exactly. But I hope you heard what I heard. And they definitely sound different. I had I got a lot of slides to copy. I mean, this is not all of them. I got a box full of different ones. You know what I mean? And even this one, this is a new one. This is ceramic. This one, who makes these? I don't know. Joe Perry is the artist. These aren't bad. This is kind of like I find these a little too heavy, but they sound good. This sounds pretty neat. And you know what? There's no rules. Here's a piece of, you can go to Home Depot and buy this for about a nickel. You know? That's just a piece of PVC pipe. Ernie Ball. Ernie Ball makes these. This is kind of neat because they make these little things that come out. This inner piece comes out for maybe cleaning. I don't know. But it fits good. It is glass, but it's black, so it's kind of an interesting. I would use this one. You know, it sounds good, but it doesn't have that tone. I hope you can hear this. I'm going to put the Duane back on. It's like, it ain't me, because Butch Trucks, not Butch Trucks, his son, what's his name? Derek Trucks. Derek Trucks. I can't remember. Butch Trucks, right? No. I think it's his nephew, Derek. I think he's also a staunch user of these. So anyway, that's just some probably useless information for most people because you can't find these, but everybody reads about them and you're just not sure. I've never seen one. I gave one of these away recently and I wish I didn't. Because I can't get any more. You know, this is it forever. But anyway, I think there's a difference. You heard it, maybe not as clear as I can hear it playing it, but maybe it's a feel difference as well. Or maybe it's like Duane Allman, like, you know, affecting it or something. Anyway, well, thanks for listening. And this is just a bunch of useless information. I'm going to put a video up of me playing a little bit of slide on this instrument. And it's kind of a fun thing to hear. So look out for that. It'll be just after this one. Thanks a lot for listening. Have a great day. And keep playing guitar, man, every day, all day, if you can.